Google's NotebookLM just got a major upgrade with Gemini 2.0. Here's how you can revolutionize the way you work, learn, and create. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today we're exploring how NotebookLM, now powered by Gemini 2.0, can transform the way you approach your daily tasks, studies, and creative projects. Whether you're using it to streamline your workflow, enhance your learning, or unlock creativity, this tool has something for everyone. Let's dive in. For the demo today, let's plan the ultimate adventure vacation using NotebookLM and Gemini 2.0. Imagine visiting breathtaking destinations like Iceland, Japan, or even a cross-country US road trip. With these tools, we can streamline the entire process from research to budgeting to content creation. I'm going to choose Japan because I've never been there and I'm super curious about learning more about their country and their culture. If you're completely new to NotebookLM, I'll put the link to this page down below in the description. I want to point out, if I go to NotebookLM Plus, that there's two different versions here. There's the free version that has all the great features that you need to use it, but there's also a Plus version that has a few more things. So I'm going to get logged into my account and start showing you how to use it. So here we are, all logged in to my account here, and you can see I have some notebooks right here with different titles or even untitled. I want to point out right away, I'm in dark mode. If you go up to these settings up top, you have different modes that you can change and set it the way you would like. You can also change this, the views from list to the grid view here as well. But I'm going to jump in and create a brand new notebook. And this is where I'm just going to add my sources. So with my trip to Japan, what I want to use NotebookLM to plan, I have a number of different things. I have some websites, I have some YouTube videos, and some PDF documents. You can see all the things that I can connect here, right here. So it shows you all the things here, connect to my Google Drive, I could put links to websites, to YouTube, and I could even copy paste in text. But I'm just going to go ahead and choose a file, because I have some PDFs on my computer. So I'm going to go to my desktop and I have a folder called Japan. I have two different ones right in here about Japan and I'm going to open those up. So right away, those two PDFs are being uploaded to my NotebookLM. Now there's more sources that I want to add. I can go back to add source. And this time, let's go ahead and add a website link. And I'm just going to copy paste links in. So for an example, if I go to this one about accommodation, I can just copy. I'm going to go Control C and just paste it in right here and insert. The other thing I might want to add is a YouTube video. So we have YouTube right here. I could go to over to YouTube, grab this link, and then I'm going to go back and paste it into here. So I'm going to go through and just update all of these different resources that I have open right now. So I have them all in one place. Now I've uploaded all my different sources that I'm going to use for this demo here. I could keep adding more, like I showed you before. The title right up here, if I wanted to change the name, maybe I just want this travel in Japan. And notice if I click this up top, it just brings me back to the Welcome to NotebookLM, and then I can go and check out any other or create new ones, but then I can click back into it. So now these are all checked off here. If you wanted to uncheck them, you can click on the top one. The reason why you could maybe check two off, you could have a conversation with the AI connecting those two sources. So if it was specifically towards that, you can narrow it down. So you've curated the information of the sources that you put in there, but then now you can go ahead, ask questions to specific documents or all of them. If you have them all checked, it's going to look at them when you're asking the questions. But if I go ahead and let's say I click on accommodation in Japan, you can see what it does here is it pulled the information off the website down here, but it gave me a summary and then it gave me key topics. So if I wanted to find out more about the price ranges, I could click on that or I'll click on this top one. Then it brings it into the chat right here. And this will allow me to go deeper into the articles, and then it will also cite everything as well. So if I look at all of these here, if I go back up, so discuss Japan accommodation, you can see it gives me the styles and everything. And if I go ahead and click on any of these citations here or hover over, it shows me where that information, if I click on it, it brings me to that source guide of it. At any time, you can collapse, close the source viewing window up there, and it goes back, and you can even collapse these if you wanted more room inside here. So you can open it back up to see everything again. Now, I'm going to prompt it to suggest a 5-day travel plan, and it's going to be connected to all these articles. So I'm just going to put this in and I'm going to send it. You can see it's based on the 8 sources, and these are the 8 sources here. If I uncheck, notice how this changes because the question won't be asked towards all the different sources. So now if I send that, it's going to go through and suggest it based on all those. So now if I go up here, so for a 5-day trip to Japan, consider spending all the 5 days in Tokyo. So it's giving me day 1, arrive in Tokyo, check in accommodation, and it goes through step by step. Again, everything is sourced if I go ahead and hover over it. Now I could quickly change this. So if I wanted it, if I say if I only had 3 days, and then I could go and have that conversation and it's going to correct it or change it to the 3-day itinerary. So now we see our day 1, day 2, day 3, and they're still telling me to go to Tokyo. Well, this is only when you only have 3 days like that. So definitely use it. If you're using it for something like a vacation, you can plan your itinerary, but now it gives you an idea how you can just discuss with any sources that you have there. A couple things I want to point out. If you look up top here, configure notebook, if I click on it, you can define your conversational style. I just have it on default, but do you want it to be an analyst, guide, custom? And you can choose your response length as well. Now, if you find this information that comes up and you want to save it, we do have save to note, and then we have a new note saved over here. You can also go ahead and copy this and paste it as well if you wanted to paste it in somewhere else. Another question I might ask would be, what's important to know about the Japanese culture? And I can send this away, again, based on those 8 sources. And here we have a list of important things to know about traveling to Japan. So this seems like another important note, so I'm going to save it as note and I'll have it over here. This is where we create our podcast, and you can actually join the podcast, ask questions to it. And I'm going to come back to this because this is definitely kind of what makes NotebookLM so special. But down here, I want to point out these great options. So I've showed you how to add a note from the results here, but we can add a note. If we go ahead and click on it, we can just type something in or take it from somewhere else to have these notes here. I'm just going to delete this one. With any of these, if I close this down now, if you notice, if you get the more option, you can always delete any of these notes. Now we have the study guide, briefing doc, FAQ, and timeline. So maybe I'd want to have an FAQ for here. So it's going to create a frequently asked questions and answers based on all these different ones I have selected. So now if I click on the FAQ, you can see here is the question, and then it gives me the answers in it. So if I go through, we have that just highlighted and made really simple. I'm going to close this up. I don't want to delete that. But we also have study guide, briefing doc, and timeline. I'm just going to click on each of these here, and then I'll show you what each of them do. This one right here, you can see, is the study guide. It's going to give instructions here, answer each of these questions in 2 or 3 sentences. This comes in so amazing if you're studying something, when you can put your notes in there or PDFs, and then it can create these guides to give a different way of learning. And then if I go down here, you'll see that there is the briefing document here. We have the Japan travel briefing document as we go through the sources and how it puts everything in. The amount of time this saves is just incredible. And then we have our travel guide right here. I'll just click on it and you can see the information that was given. Now, let's move up to the deep dive conversation. And again, I could unselect these, but I can also customize. Before I start, and I'm not going to customize this, I want to show you this, you know, things to try. Focus on specific source. So if there was a specific source I wanted to focus on from here, I could tell it to do so. focus on a specific topic. So maybe I want to know about just the etiquette of Japan. I could tell them to do that. So I could fill in this information here. Then it could really customize what you get. But I'm just going to go ahead and click generate. All right, it's all done. It only took about 3 minutes for it to finish. Notice it's 23 minutes, 41 seconds. I'm not going to play the whole thing. If I regenerated it again, it would come back at a different time and be slightly different. But if I'm going to go and play it.
All right, get ready. Today we're going deep, really deep into Japanese culture.
Sounds exciting.
We've got a ton of great sources for this deep dive.
Oh, fill me in.
We've got travel guides, etiquette advice, sustainable.
So it sounds pretty accurate to the information that they were talking about there. Notice here, we can share audio overview. If I go here, we can change the playback speed if I wanted to listen to it faster. I can download it here as well and even delete it. But what I want to show you is this interactive mode here. So this is something that Gemini 2.0, the multimodal, it allows you to interact with this now. So I'm going to allow my mic and everything. I'm going to join the conversation here when I click this button. So I'm going to hit play.
All right, get ready. Today we're going deep, really deep into Japanese culture.
Sounds exciting.
We've got a ton of great sources for this deep dive.
Oh, fill me in.
We've got travel guides.
And I'm going to click.
Our listener wants to join in. What's up?
I'm wondering if you're going to be talking about the etiquette in Japan.
Absolutely. We are definitely going to be talking about etiquette.
That's a fantastic question. And it's such an important aspect of Japanese culture.
Yeah. In fact, it's so important that we've got a whole section on it in our guide.
So isn't that great? You can jump into the conversation and make it change to certain angles depending on how you ask questions. So this is a great way if you're wanting to learn about Japan, you're listening to all these documents, you download these things, and then you'll be able to on your drive, you can hear these things, but then you can also interact with it. Again, we can close the audio overview over here. The last thing I want to point out is the share up here. If you want to give other people access to this notebook, so maybe I'm planning this with a family member or friends, I could share this notebook with them. And down here, you'll notice that the viewer access, is it on full notebook or chat only? So it's a great way to collaborate with others as well. And that's how you can use NotebookLM powered by Gemini 2.0 to transform the way you work, learn, and create, whether it's planning an epic adventure, mastering new skills, or even brainstorming your next big idea. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.